Hello YouTube, and welcome to my front yard. The sun is starting to set, and the wind that has blown the whole day has calmed down, and this is the best time for a smoke, and there are more scenic places to have them than in the front yard. I'll add a clip that was shot earlier today, so there's more sunlight than just to show the view I have. But I like just watching the traffic that goes by. There's not a lot of traffic, but you see the neighbors driving by, and they almost always greet you, and sometimes someone walks by walking their dog or passes with on a bike. And out here in the sticks, that's considered big events. You need to keep on top of what the neighbors are up to. And this time of day, the birds are still singing, but they're slowly, slowly calming down. And in an hour, the bats will start flying around here. And I really enjoy watching them. I've tried taking photos of them with my... I've just got a simple Nikon camera. And what I do is I put it on not automatic focus, but I focus at a certain distance. And I activate the flash. And when I see a bat at about that distance, I snap, or take a picture. And they're not great photos, but you can clearly see that they're bats. I might add some at the end. And what I also watch from here is the chestnut trees, or the birds that are nesting in it. There's a tremendous amount of bird traffic flying in and out. There's, I don't know, 4 or 5 species nesting in the trees. And today I'm smoking a new pipe. It's birch, and I made it yesterday. I haven't made a pipe in a very long time. I'd say it's at least 6 months since I last made one. Yesterday I went down into the basement to fetch something, I can't remember what. And then I walked by my workbench, where I have all my stuff lying. And I saw this piece of wood, it was slightly longer, and the stem was also longer, lying there, and I just felt, no, I have to make a pipe out of it now, not tomorrow or the day after tomorrow, now. And the wood had been lying there for not a year, but almost a year. It was really dry. And as I said, it's birch, but the ring on top is ash. And both trees grew on our place, or not really in the forest, just in one of the meadows. I think I was clearing part of a meadow last summer, and saw suitable pieces for pipe making. And when my boys saw me with the pipe and I was going out, for this smoke, they said that I looked like, oh no, I can't remember his English name. He's a character in the Moomin stories, the stories written and drawn by Tove Jansson, a Finnish woman, Swedish speaking, but lived in Finland, and she created this world, the Moomin world. And one of the characters is a bit of a vagabond, and he always wears a hat and he smokes a pipe. In Swedish it's called Snusmumriken, but I think Snuffkin or Snuff something is his English name. Yeah, he's a bit of character. Well, they all are in the Moomin world. But the boys thought that I looked like him. And in my pipe, I've got some not Irish flake. Like so often lately, but Brown Irish Twist from Gavin Hoggart, and that's really good as well. It's a little harder to come by here. Well, I don't think you can buy it here, but buy it on internet, since they don't ship to Sweden from the UK. And there's a will, there's a way. So I'll get hold of some more when I've finished what I've got jarred up. Evenings like this are just fantastic. Just prior coming here, sitting down, I took in the horses to the stable, and I had to stop and watch the lambs. They're really adorable. Often in the evenings they start something that we call the lamb ballet. They run around and chase each other and jump, and they're really cute. And I'll try to catch it on film, and I'll show it to you if I manage. This pipe keeps going out on me I think I'll have to focus on the pipe. So I'll stop here. Thanks for watching. Take care, and hope to see you soon again.